Sometimes, MGMT puts out an album, in a way, that pisses off some of the fans that they have gained. However, giving it one chance led to another, and over time, it's grown on me even more. I would even go as far as to say that this album has the best lyrics found on any of their records. This third LP by MGMT is appropriately named after the band, and I think it perfectly captures the essence of their music. This is MGMT's self-titled. MGMT's self-titled is certainly the weirdest album in their discography. It's weird, it's interesting, it's unique, but honestly, that's why I love it. Don't get me wrong, I didn't just listen to the album one time and think it was a masterpiece. And honestly, I had the exact same reaction when I listened to Congratulations for the first time. I liked it, I listened to it, you know, once or twice, but I didn't really see the hype. And then, just listening to it a few times and giving it a chance, it grew on me. Same thing happened to me with self-titled. I thought, man, I just like one or two of the songs in it, and then I would move on to another one and then another one, and then eventually I found myself really loving the album. And with that love for the album, I wanted to make a retrospective for it so you guys can get a second look at it. I'll tell you my favorite songs and kind of see how it came to be. So I love MGMT, but I don't participate nearly as much with the community on Reddit as I do with King Gizzard. So I don't know if the overwhelming amount of fans would have this album last in their line of favorites, but I'm gonna assume that's a fair assessment. And it's not too hard to understand why. It is very different sound-wise to most of their other releases, with a few exceptions. For example, As You Move Through the World, Days That Got Away, and Lady Dada's Nightmare are some songs I could see being on this album and not being too out of place. MGMT released the album on September 17th, 2013, and they called it MGMT. And I personally think this album is a perfect representation of the band. Even though that they said they were just being tongue-in-cheek copying the stereotype that bands always make their third album their self-titled. But I honestly do think it makes sense. Some of their other albums feature them sometimes parodying pop culture and what others are doing, and that obviously works when they do it, but this album is purely the band just being themselves. And the quality and attention to detail on these tracks prove that they had their creative juices flowing all throughout production. 10 wonderfully strange tracks appear on this album. Starting off with Alien Days, and oh man, what a start. This is definitely a fan favorite and regarded as a masterpiece in their discography. I personally think it's the best intro song to appear on any of their albums, and I know that is rivaling some very awesome songs. As Andrew Van Wingarden has stated, this song is about a parasitic alien controlling your brain, and this was also the lead single for the album and accompanied by a fantastic music video. Cool Song Number 2 is surprisingly song number 2 in the album, and it is in fact very cool. The beat all throughout draws me in every time, and my favorite part is when the percussion in the background gets very loud. Also, the music video for the song, again, is really good, and it's also pretty damn dark. Mystery Disease is one of the more catchy songs in the album, and it covers the topic of addiction. As you can probably tell, most of these songs have a pretty depressing vibe to them.
There are some times in this album where the music can be pretty dark, however the lyrics, if you read them, can be actually pretty positive. And vice versa, sometimes the music is pretty upbeat, but the lyrics can be really depressing if you read between the lines.
Introspection was another single released prior to the album's release, and is actually a cover of a Fane Jade song from 1968. I honestly didn't even know that this song was a cover until the longest time, but it doesn't change my love for this song, and it is really good. Your Life is a Lie follows, and it might be one of the funniest songs they've ever released, and the music video is definitely the funniest. The song is very short, which makes them choosing to play it on David Letterman even better.
And listen to this. Our next guests are a Grammy Award-winning band whose forthcoming self-titled album will be released in September. There it is there. Please welcome back MGMT. Yeah. Kids.
You know he's over there just sitting thinking, so this is what the kids are into these days. In my personal opinion, the next three tracks are kind of a mixed bag for me. While not bad by any means, these songs are definitely my least listened to tracks of the album. I would say I Love You to Death, as well as A Good Sadness, have its really sweet moments, and I mean, they're just nice to listen to. I just don't know if Astromancy is really my thing though. Again, I'm really open-minded and open to like a lot of stuff, I just think this one might be a little too out there for me. However, the final two songs in this album really end things on a high note. Plenty of Girls in the Sea was one of my most listened to songs in 2020, and it is absolutely the most upbeat song in this tracklist. The lyrics are absurd and funny, I mean, just like what we've been seeing all throughout the album, and I think this one is just really perfect, and I highly recommend this one if you haven't listened to it. Kind of like how I said Alien Days is my favorite intro MGMT song, An Orphan of Fortune might just be my favorite outro. This song is just trippy, it's dark, I mean, it hypnotizes me when I listen to it, and I just really enjoy it, and I think it's the perfect end to this melted ice cream of an album.
So what do you think of MGMT's self-titled album? Do you guys have a favorite song for the album, or, you know, is it just one of your least favorite albums like, you know, it seems like it is for so many? Nonetheless, I would just love to hear what you guys have to think. My personal favorites, Plenty of Girls in the Sea, Alien Days, Cool Song Number 2 is just so good as well. I'd also have to give some love to An Orphan of Fortune, as I said earlier, and Introspection is also pretty solid as well. Again, if you just think that you might need to give this album a few more tries, I highly recommend you do. It's not for everyone, but if you are an MGMT fan, I guarantee you you'll find some in this album that you would really enjoy. Two of their most recent singles, In the Afternoon and As You Move Through the World, kinda have the MGMT self-titled vibe. So who knows, maybe we will end up seeing another album with this sound again, and I'm all for it.